I'm a man in a box. Hey guys, Dibs on Title here, and on this part of Let's Play Pokemon Coliseum, we will sneak around this guy in a construction hat, because he is a complete idiot, and it looks like there's nothing else in this room, so I won't fight you. On this episode, we will continue looking around the laboratory for things, and people will randomly fall out of the sky and attack us for no apparent reason. Why would you even have that in your own lab that's abandoned? It's off limits beyond here. Well, not for me, girl. Vanna, that's actually not that bad. Good job, Nintendo. Point for you. But on this time, I always do like three intros. I gotta really stop getting better. I mean, some of my friends are like, you gotta write down what you wanna say. You gotta stop being stupid in your videos. I'm like, yeah, that's just how I am. But I am really sometimes just freaking stupid in my videos. I'm like, hey guys, on this part we're gonna go jump off a cliff. I don't know, but I was just about to say on this part. Here on this episode, we are going to, well, one thing I want to talk about during this first, oh my god, I have like conflicting things I want to do. Well, first off, we're going to start off this battle because Pupitar is a rock dark type. I'm just going to sweep it with water because Surf is such a great move. And the Surf, does it only hit the two guys on the other side in this generation? Yep, they did that in the fourth generation. I totally forgot about that. So Surf is a lot better move. Earthquake, for some reason, doesn't hit all three guys. Earthquake hits all three guys. I don't know. And Fortress, I never realized. I was going to use it when I was playing through Crystal, and it's a Shadow Pokemon in this game? Really? Oh my god, really? In competitive, Fortress is actually a great Pokemon. It's great for spikes, and if it's down on low health, and use Explosion, or you can have a Gyro Ball on it, because it's such a bit ridiculously low speed. Fortress is a pretty good competitive Pokemon, but I was going to use it for my playing through Crystal. It sucks so much. It's ridiculous. Like, I realized about this on bug type moves. I'm giving more props to the fourth generation. The fourth generation did so good at bringing badly used Pokemons higher up. Like, bug Pokemon were god awful and Gold Crystal era. Like, they have no good moves at all. Like, they added Bug Bite and I'm trying to think of other bug moves, and there's another type that they really bug. I think they added a lot of dark type moves in Diamond, Pearl, Platinum era too, and that did a lot of damage. But Fortress is just terrible. It has, I think I was looking it up because I was debating on using it on my team, then I replaced it with the Heracross. It has no stab moves at all. It has no bug moves to use at all. I think it might have one or two, steel moves, but that's it. It's just a terrible Pokemon out of competitive and out of fourth generation. Fourth generation, with all the stuff I gave it, it's great, but it is a really good defensive wall, but it doesn't look like it here because I knocked it down with that with one hit that wasn't even super effective. And I bought a bunch of Ultra Balls in between last episode because I was really running low and I still had a lot of money. And I should really talk slower. I already said that in video. You guys can understand me, so I will just talk the way I feel like because this is my channel and I will do what I want. And then I'll lose like 7 subs. I'm actually doing really good the last couple of days. Like, I don't know why I just get subs out of everywhere. I want to understand where it's coming from, so what I should do more of, but I'm just really happy to see my sub count go up. Like, my one friend Jesper, I already talked about this. He, like, was like, oh my god, your subs, he thought I still had, like, 40 subs, and why is there just, like, a black abyss? I don't know. This game is really weird, had a lot of Nintendo logic in it, and I have a feeling someone's about to fall out of the sky and attack me. How did I know? Welcome to the Shadow Pokemon Lab. Welcome to you too. And because I talked about fighting last battle, I think I'm going to talk more about, Rhyhorn, I love you. You got me credit of getting that right. I got to stop connecting this with the last episode. They're two different episodes, Scott. They're going to go around 2 different days. Don't associate them. But I think I'm just going to skip this battle, and oh no, please don't tell me. More Shadow Pokemon. I have to explain you now. Ariados sucks. It's another Gold, Silver, Crystal Pokemon that doesn't get any good moves till 4th gen, and in 4th gen it still sucks because it has terrible stats. It's still fucked. It really just has garbage stats and garbage moves, and it is, I want to say it's a Bug Poison type, which is that's an okay typing, but it just has garbage moves. They really need to give Ariados an evolution, just like all the Diamond and Pearl Pokemon. But I guess there has to be some terrible Pokemon like Dunsparce, even though some people love Dunsparce for some apparent reason, but I don't know. So, see you guys after the battle. Ooh, Grovyle. And apparently he disappears too. It's just a theme with all the guys who fly from the sky in this game. Guys who fly from the sky and they are no lie. And is there even any purpose to this room, really? Good job, and did a real good game programming. Or am I gonna pop out and there's gonna be like a bunch of thugs behind me? I'm just gonna be like, oh crap. But yeah, I'm kind of wondering, do you like that I tell like a bunch of stories and talk about topics in this game? I think it really moves it away from being a let's play and more being like, there's gonna be a person down this hallway, but I'll just continue talking. Oh no, there wasn't. I'm just gonna continue talking through fights anyway. Do you guys enjoy that this more like, and I always hate comparing this to it because it makes it seem like, oh, I'm on the same floor. I just came down that elevator. I am very stupid. It makes it seem like I'm comparing it to them, but Call of Duty commentators, it kind of what it makes me kind of like, and why is there just blinking lights back there? That was really weird. But then I do like a topic every video type thing, and phone stop ringing! Oh my god, who is it? It is anonymous private number. Anonymous is personally calling my house and getting me hacked because I suck. But it makes me kind of like a Call of Duty commentator that I just like do a topic every video. Do you guys enjoy that, or do you think that's too like, and I'm surprised there's not a person like guarding this. Please be Earthquake. Full restore. I don't need a full restore. Oh, it went to my PC? Am I full of items? Seriously, I have to get rid of some stuff. Well, I could use these PP ups on something. But do you guys really think it like makes me too? And I gotta check the PP of some moves. Well, I'll do that later. Let me just see if there's anything I can get rid of. Soak Scar. Nah, Macho Braze. No. Awakening. I should sell some of these items later. But do you really like it not being let's play it, especially this let's play? Minecraft is more talking about the game, because that's like, sweeties, you've already caused enough mischief already. It makes this game like, it's just kind of my like, what was that thing painters paint on? Palette? No, palette's the thing they put the colors on. But canvas, there we go. It makes it my like canvas for like vlogging-ish to you guys while I play a very fun game that I talk about too. Do you guys like all the stories and stuff? And oh, am I gonna have to talk about another terrible Pokemon? I don't know why they just, in this game, so many of the shadow Pokemon are just garbage. Just like Granbull. Granbull is another average normal type. There's nothing real to say about it. It's an okay Pokemon. It's just, it sucks. Like, that makes no sense. It's okay, but it sucks. It just, I've never seen anyone ever use a Granbull. Granbull is just a not very good Pokemon. It looks like it has high defense. I've really never used one personally myself, but it's just terrible Pokemon. And did Flinnion just use Tail Whip? Really? It just, the AI and the Pokemon they chose in this game, the Shadow Pokemon, it's just like, I wonder if they're just trying to make it a challenge, even though everyone pretty much chooses, everyone that I've seen like Let's Play videos of, and me personally stuff, I always pretty much go with the same team. I keep Umbreon and Espeon. You use one of the dogs or more. If you use all three of the dogs, that's kind of just like, it's kind of pretty much cheating, because they're the strongest 3.1 in the game, and it Nintendo is kind of like, looks like they're trying to force you to do it, because there's just a lot of terrible Pokemon in this game. And even though the dogs, I was really surprised, I actually looked them up, because my one friend was like, why don't you make a team with all the dogs, because he's never seen competitive battling before. He's like, why don't you put them on a competitive team? But I looked them all up, and Suicune is the only one who's, Suicune still should be OU, and because Suicune is actually a pretty decent Pokemon, but I think Entei is never used, and Raikou is underused, there's one of those two back and forth, but I was surprised how terrible they are for legendary Pokemon. I mean, I expect them to be a lot stronger, and let's just do this on her. And her or him, I didn't even check. I never even look at the genders of Pokemon. It really doesn't matter. Pretty much it doesn't matter for everything except Attract, and Attract is just annoying and no one uses it, but I just don't understand why they didn't put better Shadow Pokemon in this game, but Whatever, there's nothing I can do about it now unless I go back in time and hit someone at Nintendo over the head. Even though Nintendo's in Japan, I would have to... I don't know, time travel doesn't work. But another thing I want to talk about in this video that was just really grinding at my gears and... not what grind my gears, besides the fact that this is kind of becoming like a vlog type thing with Pokemon. I love how I was talking about the vlog thing and it just slowly coming back to my head of what I was talking about before that I was trying to avoid the not notice that I forgot what I was talking about and I just brought it up and I keep doing that. I don't know why I just tell every single thing that's on my mind. Your mischief is going overboard. It's going critical. But just, is this coming too vlog-like for you guys? I mean, I love Let's Playing and I love talking to you guys like vlog-like, but it just seems like I'm losing the heart of Let's Playing. I gotta watch that video by Mickey D. It looks pretty interesting on how he was saying Let's Playing was dying. He does have a good point there, but... And I'm going to follow this up with a vlog-type topic, even though I don't want to go into more fights. Okay, I'm just gonna skip this fight, because you've already seen like 3 fights already this video. You don't need to see more.
Aw, oh, crud. There's no way I'm gonna let you go.
No, what are you doing? Oh no! Wah, you're stuck now! There's no escaping the lab for you! What? Dude! Boom, boom! Can I just like break something? Why is there no punch button? What are we gonna do? The alarms are so loud! I can't hear myself think! What are we gonna do? What is this? Oh my god, there's people falling from the sky! Oh my god, okay, I can stop yelling. But... yeah, so it looks like we're being chased by the alarms now, and now we gotta fight this stupid falling from the sky who knew we were coming because of the stupid alarms. But during this battle, I would like to talk about something so you guys get a little bit of battle talk and a little bit of that. I just want to talk about school in general and another shadow Pokemon, Vibria. Vibria is a freaking awesome Pokemon that evolves into... Dragonfly. I should think about actually using this Pokemon on my team. I might, but I think I've I don't know. Do you guys, I'll leave you comment down below. Who would you rather have on my team? Hitmontop or Vibria? Leave a comment down below. But Vibria evolves into Dragonfly, an amazing Pokemon. And watch this, now I'm not gonna catch it, I'm just gonna be so pissed. But Vibria evolves into an amazing Pokemon. Vibria, and it is overall really, really awesome Pokemon. Now I have to be careful with my Surf because I want to try to catch it. I guess I'll just bite it. But roleplay, roleplay—that's actually a really good ability for double battles. I remember actually seeing it used for what was that? There's stop calling my house when I try to make videos. The last 2 calls have been the stupidest IDs ever. What is this one? Oh, it's my sister's boyfriend. Yay, good for you, Danielle. But, just, roleplay is actually a really great move for, I remember, there's something with, like, competitive double battles I remember seeing. Like, someone would have a Pokemon with Sheer Cold, and then there's an ability that I think the Pokemon never misses or something, and they would roleplay, they would swap the ability with Sheer, with a, stop ringing so I can make a video. They would swap the ability so Sheer Cold would never miss, because all the Pokemon will level 100, and it would just, you'd be done, because if Sheer Cold never misses, you're just completely owned, because Sheer Cold is a one-hit KO move, but then again, the Pokemon would have to hold up to a bunch of attacks of the other guys doing them, because it's a double battle, but furthermore, I'm going on to a different subject, and Vibrio, please be caught, and remember to leave a comment down below about who you want me to choose, Vibrio or Hitmontop. I'll remind you at the end of the video if I remember, and please catch. Cool. So, the thing I want to talk about in this video is school in general. I mean, I get decent grades. I mean, I got like a 3.2 GPA or something at a pretty like high level school, but not trying to be like, oh yeah, I'm so smart, because I'm not really compared to the other kids there. But school in general, I mean, there's like at points I'm just like, why are we learning? Why are we wasting our time and money with kids learning this crap? And Kelkeon's 3D model looks really cool, but sometimes I just don't understand. Like algebra, even I might sound a bit hypocritical. And oh great, you're using Fly. I'm doing terrible in algebra, but when I'm learning it, I mean, I'm kind of learning it, and it was just because I didn't understand some of the sections. I sound like I'm explaining my thing like I would explain to my mom, like, I didn't do bad, I swear. But It's just like, when will I ever use any of this stuff in life when you're learning it? Just some of the stuff is just so dumb. Like, I can't even name something from it. It's just like, no, why? X over 4b y squared over m. Okay, when am I gonna use that? You'll use that when you're finding out the half-life of a cosmic thing of carbon 14. I'm not gonna be a scientist. Teach this to the people who want to be a scientist. Like, why don't they have kids who know they want to be a scientist or something? They pick their things and they become more specialized in that. That would maybe make our jobs actually better. And Calculon has this cool ability where every time you attack it, it changes its type to whatever you attacked it with, which is actually really, really cool. I think that's a cool ability, but it just doesn't work very well. But I just don't understand half the things in school that we learn and we're never going to use in life. And I can see, like, essay writing. I kind of see that, how you can, like, learn it and, it kind of helps, like, if you ever have to do a job thing for your boss or you have to advertise something of your own business. I can kind of see that, but algebra is just, like, really stupid. And also, I don't want to sound like atheist by saying this, but religion class in school. I mean, it is, like, I do kind of go to, like, a Catholic-ish school, but you don't need to teach religion and waste one of the 8 periods a day just teaching things that I already know. And half the homework for that class is just BSing around. I mean, all you have to do is like, God is good, praise the Lord Jesus. It's just like, I don't understand. They should really spend it on educating people instead of teaching them religions that... I'm not trying to like cause people to hate me or stuff, but you have no proof that your religion is true. And I'm not atheist. I'm like... I don't know what my religion is. I will talk about that in another episode if you really want to, but walking around that subject is just like, you gotta tiptoe, because some people get so mad with that, and alarms again! So I think I'm gonna end this episode off here. Next time on Let's Play Pokemon Coliseum, we will stop these alarms, hopefully. And I don't know what hell I'm gonna save this if I can't escape or something. I hope I can save it, because I'll be really annoyed if I can, because then I'll just have to wait here. So next time we will set the alarm off, well, we will unset the alarm, and we'll go do something else. See you guys next time. Oh yeah, and I gotta remind you real quick, vote down below who you would like to be on my team, Hitmontop or Vibria. I will be reading all your comments of how many two of them, and I will tally them up to give you a true leader of who will be on my team and who will not. You have control of Saves on Titles teams. Vote now! Or later.